I got two pieces for you. I got since it's Black History Month, not Valentine's or Lincoln or Washington's birthday month. It's Black History Month, so I got a piece I'm doing from a black man. His name is Franklin or Jay, and I got a piece I'm doing of my own. So which one do you want to hear first, mine's or his? Check it out. Y'all see? Which one do y'all want to hear first? Which one do y'all want to hear first? Can I get to the poetry shit? Can you hear me, Corey? Okay, cool. All right, cause I thought the word was all right. Fuck it, man. Here we go, man. All right, here we go. Be black, brother. Be black. My name is an African name, but it's real, see? I had it before it was worthwhile to have it, see? I struggled with it for years. You know what I mean? Because before it was hip to have an African name, it was a disgrace to have it. Shit, I had to carry the burden on my ass, you know? But then it got hip, see? And brothers started changing their names, which I didn't mind, except they wouldn't give me no warning. Overnight, they just become another person, you know? You say, hey, Fat Cat, what's happening? My name ain't Fat Cat. God damn, you sure look like Fat Cat. Can't be two dudes in America that ugly with the same name. Fat Cat, why you bullshitting? My name ain't Fat Cat. It's Mbutu Yada. Got meaning. I got a name with meaning. I got it out of the book last night. I was just reading. Oh, yeah? What does it mean? It means warrior with big jump shot. Got meaning, man. It's about my people. I ain't going to answer that slave shit, Fat Cat, no more, you did? But then a chick will walk by and be like, hi, Fat Cat, how are you? Oh, I'm all right, looking good, baby. See, I took Black History, hardest class in school. Learned a lot of interesting facts, though. I found out that a black man, Matthew Henson, was actually the first man to actually set foot on the North Pole. A black man. Y'all didn't know that, huh? Y'all know that. Google that, Wikipedia. Learn that, man. But you gotta take it with a grain of salt. You know, because you gotta know that the only reason Matt Henson was the first one allowed to set foot on the North Pole was because the Admiral Perry went, that looks like a little thin up there, doesn't it? Nah, keep the dogs back. Hey, Matthew, come here, put that skillet down. I need you to check out something for me. And that was Be Black, Brother, Be Black, 1977, Franklin and Jay. You're good to go with my piece? Huh? Can't top that? All right, here we go. This one is called Little Red. Go ahead, what's the question? We have what? Thinking about this, my nails. You're talking about ain't nothing gold. That's regular. No polish. See the polish? That's the twinkle. That's the twinkle of the lights in the room, man. Leave me alone. Okay, Little Red. That's the twinkle in the. All right. There once was a teenage girl named Little Red who decided to go riding in the hood one night before bed. She thought she was clever or somewhat slick. She just wanted to be liked, you know, part of the clique. So she went. And went out and chased her first opportunity to experience some dick. The grandmother's house was the story she told. Instead, she stayed the night at Goldie's house. Pretty bold. See, so Goldie was well known for playing with bears. But she knew Little Red wasn't ready to sit in the big chair. So Goldie invited the little bad wolf and Lil Red was okay with him tasting her cookie to satisfy his sweet tooth. All these things were all good, well understood, days before Lil Red went riding in the hood. So the hour was late and the moon was shining, and Lil Red makes it to Goldie's door. She had feelings of nervousness that's exciting, unknowing what to fully encounter. In she walks, but feels a bit lost. To her surprise, she couldn't believe her eyes. See, Little Red hoped Little Bad Wolf wouldn't show, so her and Goldie's friends would have time to grow. Her and Goldie's friendship would have time to grow. A BFF, she hoped, but what her eyes witnessed almost made her choke. What Little Red didn't know about the hood is that a wolf rolls in the pack, and wolves go hard wolfing, and ain't nothing sweet about that. Little Bad, Baby Bad, Tiny Bad Wolf too. Bad and Big Bad sharing precious treats of gold. Woo! And poor Goldie trying to handle more meat than she can chew. Little Red was never the same after that night. Grew up too fast, too soon, just to be like. True BFFs like you for staying true to who you are, for being an original and twinkle bright amongst all stars. The moral of that story is, don't go chasing waterfalls, stick to the streams that you're used to. All right, here goes. And say hi to the Austins who come. Yeah. Yeah. Wilson. Check it out. These are the. I'm gonna talk to him. Hey, excuse me, hey. Good day, mate. Appreciate you guys. Finished my Snicker that cost $2.40 that I paid only $1.20 for. Thank you. Love you. All right, box. My man. Okay. Dina boy. With a cactus cooler. Eating Vegemite, huh? Snicker, cool. Dude.